Hello everyone, this is Bullion Babai. This is a series we'll be trying to understand the legal provisions, the rights of accused, legal provisions regarding rights of accused. Now what are all the things that we'll learn in this series? First, who is the accused under the rule of law? And second, the rights of accused under the Code of Criminal Procedure in India. Third, part of it. Second one, protection against arbitrary and illegal arrest. And part of that is when police may arrest without a warrant, notice of appearance before a police officer, procedure of arrest and duties of officer making the arrest, control room at districts, right of arrested person to meet an advocate of his choice during interrogation, arrest and refusal to give name and residence, arrest by a private person and the procedure on such arrest, arrest how it's to be made, search of place entered by person sought to be arrested, no unnecessary restraint, person arrested to be informed of the grounds of arrest and of the right to get a bail, obligation of the person making arrest to inform about the arrest to a nominated person or a relative, search of an arrested person, examination of the accused by the medical practitioner at the request of the police officer, examination of the person accused of rape by medical practitioner, examination of the arrested person by medical practitioner at the request of the arrested person, identification of the person arrested, procedure when police officer deputes subordinate to arrest without a warrant, health and safety of arrested person, person arrested not to be detained more than 24 hours, police to report apprehensions, arrest to be made strictly according to the code, arrest to prevent the commission of cognizable offences. This is the second part. And the third part will be protection against search of an accused's premises of the accused. When search warrants may be issued, search of a place suspected to contain stolen property or forged documents, search for persons wrongfully confined, persons in charge of closed place to allow search, search by a police officer. And a part of that next is right to be produced before the magistrate within 24 hours of arrest. And two items are there under it. Person arrested to be taken before a magistrate or officer in charge of a police station. Person arrested not to be detained more than 24 hours. And the fifth part is right to consult and to be defended by a counsel of his choice and to get free legal aid in case of economically disabled persons, right of person against whom proceedings are instituted to be defended, legal aid to the accused at the state expense in certain cases. Then there is a right to open trial, courts to be open, right of the accused to examine the witness in his presence, evidence to be taken in the presence of the accused, right to get copies of statements of prosecution witnesses and other documents, supply to the accused of copy of police report and other documents, supply of copies of statements and documents to accused in other cases triable by a court of session, accused not to be prosecuted more than once for the same offence, right of the accused to have a notice of charge, contents of charge, particulars as to the time, place and person, when the manner of committing offence must be stated. Next is right to examine the defence witnesses, entering upon defence, evidence for defence in warrant cases instituted otherwise than on police report, calling upon the accused to produce witness in his defence when not convicted in trial of summons cases by the magistrate. Next item is right to cross-examine the prosecution witnesses, evidence for prosecution, recording of prosecution evidence in warrant cases instituted otherwise than on police report before a magistrate, right to get the matter settled through plea bargaining, new chapter, applicability of this chapter, application for plea bargaining, guidelines for mutually satisfactory disposition, report of the mutually satisfactory disposition to be submitted before the court, disposal of the case, judgment of the court, finality of judgment, power of the court in plea bargaining, period of detention undergone by the accused to be set off against the sentence of imprisonment, statement of accused not to be used, non-application of the chapter. Next item is right to be heard on question of sentence in the warrant cases, judgment of acquittal or conviction in cases triable by a magistrate, rights to file appeal against the order of the conviction and amendment to it, right to move the High Court in case of refusal of trial, special powers of High Court or a court of session regarding bail, right to explain his case by way of giving a statement, power to examine the accused, the right to appear as a defense witness, accused person to be a competent witness, then right to get bail under special circumstances, right to bail on failure of the prosecution to complete investigation within the stipulated period, right to bail in bailable offences, maximum period for which an under trial prisoner can be detained, why bail may be taken in case of a non-bailable offence, bail to require accused to appear before the next appellate court, special powers of High Court or a court of session regarding bail. Then there is a right of accused to get the complaint filed against him for the alleged offence within the period of limitation, bar to taking cognizance after lapse of the period of limitation, commencement of the period of limitation, exclusion of time in certain cases, exclusion of date on which court is closed, continuing of offence, extension of the period of limitation in certain cases, protection against police from extorting a confession by using illegal methods in the form of force and coercion. That is 3rd D. Police's power to require attendance of the witness, examination of the witness by the police, statement to police not to be signed, no inducement to be offered, recording of confessions and statements, inquiry by magistrate into the cause of death, then compensation for the accusation without reasonable cause, right to anticipatory bail in certain circumstances, direction for grant of bail to person apprehending arrest. Next is unlawful assemblies. Dispersal of an assembly by use of civil force, use of armed forces to disperse assembly. Then you have rights of the accused under the Code of Criminal Procedure. First is protection against arbitrary or illegal arrest. When police may arrest without warrant under Section 41, notice of appearance before a police officer, that is 41A, procedure of arrest and duties of officer making arrest, Section 41B, control room at a district, Section 41C, right of arrested person to meet an advocate of his choice during interrogation, Section 41D, arrest on refusal to give name and residence, Section 42, arrest by private person and procedure on such arrest, Section 43, arrest how made, Section 46, search of a place entered by person sought to be arrested, Section 47, no unnecessary restraint, Section 49, person arrested to be informed of the grounds of arrest and of the right to bail, Section 50, obligation of the person making arrest to inform about the arrest to a nominated person, Section 50A, search of arrested person, Section 51, examination of the accused by medical practitioner at the request of the police officer, Section 53, examination of the person accused of rape by a medical practitioner, Section 53A, examination of the accused by medical practitioner at the request of the arrested person, Section 54, identification of the person arrested, Section 54A, procedure when police officer deputes a subordinate to arrest without a warrant, Section 55, health and safety of the arrested person, Section 55A, person arrested not to be detained more than 24 hours, Section 56 and 57, police to report apprehension, Section 58, arrest to be made strictly according to the court, Section 60A, arrest to prevent the commission of cognizable offences, Section 151, then protection against search of an accused premises. Then you have one, search warrants may be issued as per Sections 91, 92 and 93, search of the place suspected to contain stolen property or forged documents, Section 94, search for persons wrongfully confined, Section 97, person in charge of closed place to allow search, Section 100, search by police officer, Section 165. Then is the right to be produced before a magistrate within 24 hours of arrest. Now what are the sections? 1. Person arrested to be taken before a magistrate or officer in charge of a police station, Section 56. Person arrested not to be detained more than 24 hours, Section 57. Right to consult and to be defended by a counsel of his choice and to get free legal aid in case of economically disabled accused. Right of a person against whom proceedings are instituted to be defended, it is Section 303. Legal aid to accused at state expense in certain cases, Section 304. Right to open trial, it is a court to be opened, Section 327. Right of the accused to examine the witness in his presence, evidence to be taken in the presence of accused, Section 273. Right to get copies of statements of the prosecution witness and other documents. Supply to the accused of the copy of police report and other documents, Section 207. Supply of copies of statements and documents to the accused in the other cases, tribal by court of session, Section 208. Accused not to be prosecuted more than once for the same offence, Section 300. Right of accused to have notice of charge. Contents of charge, section 211. Particulars as to the time, place and person, section 212. When the matter of committing offence may be stated, section 213. Right to examine the defence witnesses. Entering upon defence, section 233. Evidence for defence, 243. Evidence for defence in warrant cases instituted otherwise than in police report, section 247. Calling upon the accused to produce witness in his defence when not convinced. When not convicted. In trial of summons cases by the magistrate, section 254. Right to cross-examine the prosecution witness. Evidence for prosecution, section 231. Recording of prosecution evidence in warrant cases instituted otherwise than on police report before magistrate, section 246. Right to be heard on question of sentence in warrant cases. Evidence for prosecution, section 231. Recording of prosecution evidence in warrant cases instituted otherwise than on police report before a magistrate, section 246. Right to be heard on question of sentence in warrant cases, judgment of acquittal or conviction, section 235. Acquittal or conviction in cases tribal magistrate, section 248. Right to file appeal against the order of conviction, suspension of sentence pending the appeal order of conviction, section 389. Right to move the higher court in case of a refusal of bail, special power of high court or court of sessions regarding bail, section 439. Right to explain his case by way of giving a statement. Power to examine the accused, section 313. Right to appear as a defense witness. Accused person to be competent witness, section 315. Right to get bail under special circumstances. Right to bail on failure of prosecution to complete the investigation within the stipulated period, section 167. Right to bail in bailable offense, section 436. Maximum period for which an under trial prisoner can be detained, section 436A. When bail may be taken in case of non-bailable offence, section 437. Bail to require accused to appear before the next appellate court. Special power of High Court or Court of Session regarding bail, section 439. Right of accused to get the complaint filed against him for alleged offence within the period of limitation. Bar to taking cognizance after lapse of the period of limitation, section 468. Commencement of the period of limitation, the period of limitation, section 469. Exclusion of time in certain cases, section 470. Exclusion of date on which court is closed, section 471. Continuing of offence, section 472. Extension of period of limitation in certain cases, section 473. Protection against police from extorting confession by using illegal methods in the form of force, coercion in third degree. Police power to require attendance of extorting confession by using witness, section 160. Examination of witness by police, section 161. Statement to police not to be signed, section 162. No inducement to be offered, section 163. Recording of confessions and statements, section 164. Inquiry by magistrate into the cause of death, section 176. Compensation for accusation without reasonable cause, section 250. Right to anticipatory bail in certain circumstances. Direction for grant of bail to person apprehending arrest, section 438. Unlawful assembly. Disposal of assembly by use of civil force, section 129. Use of armed forces to disperse the assembly, section 130. So these are all the summary of various provisions of the rights of the accused. Thanks for watching.